Australia has a serious problem. The rise of crystal meth, commonly known as ice, is tearing our country apart. Ice is highly addictive and it's relatively cheap, and a lot of it is produced right here in Australia. But this epidemic doesn't just ruin the lives of addicts. Laura Banks experienced this firsthand when the addiction of her partner became her addiction. She's written about it and she joins us now. Welcome, Laura. You are a journalist. How difficult was it, though, to put on a different hat and to write about this really deep pain that you had?
As I was talking to Jessica and Aita just before, it kind of just fell out. I think when you write something from the heart and you write something that you feel, it's not that difficult to write.
I remember when you sent it to me the other night and you said, I said, look, I don't even know if this is worth putting in the newspaper, but it just felt so good to finally write it out.
It's cathartic, I think.
Yeah. Tell us exactly what happened. Your ex-partner, you started noticing some strange behaviour, and tell us how it all happened.
Yeah, I didn't know at first that he was using ice. He became a little bit more erratic and more irritable, and you put two and two together and you sort of work out what's going on, and then the battle began to try and convince him to stop.
You say he'd go missing. Yeah. He'd go missing for sometimes weeks at a time.
Yeah. From what I understand of ice and when you're taking it and when you're on it, it becomes your world. Days become weeks, and time becomes irrelevant. So,
how long were you two a partnership?
18 months, 2 years.
And you never saw any warning signs in him?
Yes. I guess there is a personality that was perhaps susceptible to following that path, but I loved him, and I guess you get blinded by love too.
Mm. I suppose. Yeah, but what happened when you approached him? How did you tackle it?
Probably not in the right way. I tried the softly, but that didn't work. And try arguing, a whole range of emotions, just, you're watching someone you love completely change their personality, their life just starts to crumble around them.
Did he admit the addiction when you tackled him with it?
Yeah, I knew what he was doing. He knew that I knew what I was doing.
But did he admit it to you that he had a problem?
No. And that's, I guess that's the issue. Until somebody can admit that they have a problem, they can't address the problem. Mm.
Tell us about some of his behaviour, Laura. Tell us some of the things he did.
He'd been missing, if you like, for a period of time, a week, maybe two. We went out for breakfast, for brunch, which I was, it was these little small things that you think, oh, he's coming back, he's okay. Mm. And he was a bit erratic, he was okay, but I crossed my knife and fork over, and I always cross my knife and fork when I'm finished a meal. It's just something I grew up doing. And it irritated him so much to the point where he yelled at me for doing it, first of all, and asked why I'd done it. I said, I always do that. It was.
And this is in the middle of a crowded cafe.
Yeah, and it was quite irrational. And then he just couldn't handle it, and he threw the table up in the middle of the cafe, which was humiliating.
Was he violent with you?
He had violent. There were points. Yes, he was. He never hit me. He didn't do anything like that. But there was, physical element.
You write that at one point, I think he dragged you out of the apartment and
yes,
and dragged you into a lift, and you were so scared that you...
I slept in the car, yeah.
Oh, goodness. And so what made you stay? Because obviously you say you loved him. You're kind of blinded by love. Was there a point where you just thought, you know what, I have to walk away from this man?
He walked away from me in the end, because he was coming down at one point, and the guy that I loved and that I met and the real him came through, and he looked at me, and I had been crying, I hadn't been eating, I was a mess, and he looked in my eyes and he could see what he was doing to me, and he said he wasn't ready to give it up, but he wasn't going to ruin my life. Mm. And he did that for me.
So he chose ice over you?
Yeah. But he also knew that he wasn't ready to beat it, and he didn't want me to ruin my life anymore.
Do you know where he is today?
I understand he's doing good. I don't speak with him, but I understand that he's trying his best and has started to turn his life around.
You say in your article that he was a good boy from a good family.
Yes.
You know, did he hold a job down? It just seems so kind of irrational that someone who's from such a normal place can descend into this madness so quickly.
Yes, but I hear so many stories of situations like this. I have a friend whose ex-wife was addicted to ice, and he had no idea they were trying for a family. She one day came to him and said, "I want a divorce," and started moving out the next day, and he found the paraphernalia in the glove box of her car when he was helping her move out of their house. Since I've written this story, I've been contacted, this morning on social media, with people telling me the same stories, that it is a really common occurrence, that it's...
It can happen to anyone.
It can happen to anyone. It's not just people from low socioeconomic backgrounds that this happens to. It's happening to everybody. And it's affecting all demographics.
Mm. And right under people's noses.
Right under people's noses. And I guess what's, people who hold down a good job can probably afford to do it and perhaps go under the radar a little bit more because they're not having to beg, borrow and steal to feed their addiction. They're able to feed their addiction themselves.
And then they lose that job, it all falls apart.
Yeah. Yeah,
I think you're a very brave girl because I see it a lot in my business. I think you're a very brave girl. And the only thing I wanted to ask you, which we didn't ask you, did you notice the change in his skin? And, you know, because it does, it changes people's appearance, it ages them.
He lost an awful lot of weight and he became very drawn in the face, and it broke my heart.
I know, sweetheart, but I tell you what, you've got to thank him one thing. He walked away because he could have done more damage.
And he knew
I see a lot of it, and I just think you're very brave.
Thank you.
It's an incredible thing.
Laura, thank you so much for sharing your story. Hopefully people watching at home can pick up on some warning signs or get some help if they need it. If you know someone who needs help or you would like to find out more, you can call the Family Drug Helpline on 1300 660 068. The number is open 24 hours a day.